There's a number of diseases associated with the respiratory and circulatory systems, and I want to just touch on a few of the most common that you might hear about regularly. The respiratory system is unfortunately a very easy access for bacteria, viruses, fungi, or harmful physical particles to get into the body. Every time you breathe in, you are sucking in all of these things into your lungs. And so the respiratory system has to deal with fighting off these potential infectious agents. It's built to do this. It knows that it might be getting those things. And so the cells that line the upper part of the respiratory system in your trachea and pharynx, these cells have hairs and they produce mucus. And so the idea is the mucus is sort of sticky, and as you breathe in bacteria, fungi, viruses, or particles, they'll get trapped in the mucus. And then the little hairs are constantly waving up, and so they will wave that mucus up out of your respiratory system, most importantly, keeping them from getting launched down in the bronchioles and down into the alveoli. Cough is another great way to get some of these things out of your respiratory system. And a cough is just when the epiglottis traps air in the lungs. So you're breathing out and you're trying to push air out, but the epiglottis stays closed over the trachea. It builds up pressure, and then when you release that, you get a force of air that's going to push invaders and that built-up mucus out of your body. So smoking is a problem for many reasons, but we'll start with the first one here. It's going to burn the hairs that line the system. So I just said those hairs are essential in waving mucus out of your system, and if you lose those hairs, you can't get that mucus out as much. And if you know someone who is a chronic smoker, you know they have what's called smoker's cough. They're constantly trying to move that mucus out that the hairs aren't able to wave out naturally for them. In addition, your alveoli become less elastic. Those little alveoli are like little balloons that fill up with air and then close back down. And they just aren't as elastic. You can't get as much air into your lungs or out after your alveoli are less elastic. And then finally, smoking introduces over 1,000 different carcinogens, and these are chemicals that cause cells to become cancerous. And we'll talk more about cancer a little bit later. A good friend of mine pointed out that the reason people smoke is not to cause damage to their lungs. So if you're a smoker, I would encourage you to think about what it is in your life that smoking makes you feel better about. Typically, people are smoking for psychological reasons. It makes you feel better. It relaxes you. And so the question isn't so much for me to show you black lungs and explain all the horrible things that it's doing. It's to think about why am I smoking, and is there something else I could do, some other coping mechanism that's healthier for me that I could switch to. Other issues that come up in the respiratory system. Bronchitis is an inflammation of the bronchi, and these are the main tubes going down into each of your lungs. And sort of basic physics, if you inflame those tubes, if they get smaller, it's harder to get air in and out. Bronchitis can be due to a virus or a bacteria. So bronchitis is just the symptom. It's the result of some kind of infection. You get too much mucus built up down in the lungs, and it gets hard to clear and more difficult to breathe. Asthma is a condition where the bronchi and the bronchioles, the smaller tubes, become constricted, inflamed, or congested with mucus. And again, this is a symptom, and it can be caused by a number of different things. It can be triggered by smog, other particles from air pollution. There can be a genetic component of people being more likely to get asthma. The typical treatment for asthma is a breathing treatment of steroids, and steroids will reduce inflammation, sort of open up those airways and help people breathe a little bit better. Unfortunately, here in the Central Valley, we have a lot of air pollution issues and fine particulate matter, and asthma is a huge problem, especially childhood asthma in the Central Valley of California. The circulatory system has a number of different issues as well. One of the problems you can have is a buildup of fatty deposits in the blood vessels. And this is going to lead to the things I already talked about, where we get blockages in different blood vessel systems. So this can lead to heart attacks or strokes. Now, there are ways to deal with this. These buildups of deposits can increase blood pressure and lead to blood vessel blockages, like we already talked about, the coronary system, or to the brain that could lead to a heart attack or a stroke. There's a number of ways to deal with these kind of buildups. One is to take a medication that thins your blood. Blood thinners can be very effective, but they can also be dangerous because you can't have surgery, you worry about getting cut or being in a car accident, your body's not going to clot the way it's supposed to. You can also treat specific clot areas with something called balloon angioplasty. And this is where they put a small tube into a vein in your leg and they snake it all the way up to an area of your heart that has a blockage. And it's got a little balloon at the end, and once they reach the blockage, they expand that out and it helps open up that particular vein or artery. Sometimes you'll hear about someone getting a stent put in. A stent is just a small piece of plastic that they put in one of these blockage areas to sort of prop that vein or artery open. And that can be an effective treatment to help reduce issues with these fatty deposit buildups. The most extreme solution is bypass surgery. And this is when they take a vein from your leg, they remove it, and they put it in your heart to patch over a full blocked area. So they'll just go around it with this new vein. If someone has double bypass, they had to go around two blockages. Triple bypass, they had to go around three. That's pretty major surgery and pretty dangerous, though. Much less extreme is something called varicose veins, and this is when the valves in the veins start to fail. Remember that the lowest pressure in your circulatory system is at the veins because they're as far away from the heart as you can be, and they have these little valves that prevent blood from flowing backwards through the system. And sometimes those start to leak, the veins start to collapse a little bit, and blood pools. And this can be a little bit painful, especially in the legs, and sometimes you'll see older people have what look like very spider web dense blood vessels near the skin. Those are called varicose veins. And they can actually be fixed surgically as well. That's more of a cosmetic kind of surgery to fix those varicose veins unless they've become particularly painful.